In the past 50 years, coastal erosion and climate change have caused this species, the most widespread in the Mediterranean, to decrease by 34%, also thanks to humans. And the mismanagement of the coastline has led to...
It's green, it lives at the bottom of the sea.
It's salty.
There are fish, a lobster, a starfish, a seahorse, a sea urchin.
And behind them, what is there? Do you know what that is?
Yes, algae. Oceanic or local? Is there Posidonia in Sicily too?
Is it visible?
So along the coast, you can see mountains of Posidonia. Here in front, there's as much as you want. Well, you know, all of Augusta was full of Posidonia. And Posidonia is a refuge for fish, starfish. It's a breeding ground.
Did you see it?
Yes, I touched it with my feet. My mom finds it creepy.
I thought so. What about you?
It tickled my feet.
Although often confused with algae, Posidonia oceanica is a marine plant, endemic to the Mediterranean Sea, where it forms extensive meadows spreading along the coasts. It prefers clear waters and lives at a depth that varies from a few centimeters to roughly 40 meters. Like land plants, it has roots, leaves, and a stalk, called rhizome. At least 1% of Mediterranean seabeds are covered by its meadows, which produce roughly 20 liters of oxygen per square meter daily, beneficial to the coastal ecosystem. In addition, the carbon dioxide captured and trapped by the plant is taken away from the environment, helping to mitigate climate change. Like the large forests on land, the meadows of Posidonia oceanica host great biodiversity, estimated at about 25% of Mediterranean marine species. Many organisms live in the different parts of the plant, since they find nourishment and protection in the meadow. Thanks to the dense cover consisting of long ribbon-like leaves, the Posidonia meadows attenuate the energy of waves that crash on the beaches, helping to reduce the erosion that afflicts our coasts. In addition, the interweaving of rhizomes and roots traps the sediment, stabilizing the seafloor through the typical terrace formation known as mate. The state of health of these seagrass meadows is an excellent indicator of the quality of the marine environment. Where Posidonia is in good health, so are the sea and its ecosystems. Unfortunately, the Posidonia meadows are declining throughout the Mediterranean basin, and it is estimated that their area has decreased by more than 30% in the last 50 years. Human activities and related forms of pollution are among the main threats to this ecosystem.
When I was little, it used to be full of Posidonia, but there hasn't been any here in years.
We were told there was a beautiful meadow here until the 1950s. Then, when the petrochemical complex was built, the waste that was dumped into the sea destroyed it all.
We calculated the damage to the meadow, and we're talking about a stretch that goes from Siracusa to Augusta. So the entire petrochemical complex, covering about 2,000 hectares, In economic terms, we cannot even assess the damage. We're talking about tens, if not hundreds of billions of euros of damage that have been done to the local economy.
Other human activities which can damage the meadows are illegal trawling and anchoring of recreational crafts and large commercial vessels.
Well, what I want to denounce is the ripping out of Posidonia that takes place every day by the speedboats that anchor here. And there are many, lots and lots. And this is something that must be exposed.
The construction or extension of marinas and commercial ports, the laying of coastal defense works, and the installation of cables of underwater pipelines often lead to the breaking of large portions of meadow. In addition, the increase in turbidity of the water due to the suspension of sediment generated by human activities reduces the effectiveness of photosynthesis, causing damage to the plant. Did you hear what happened in Civitavecchia at the meadow that was at La Mattonara? They enlarged the port here, and to build this extension of the port and dock, a large part of the Posidonia meadow there was destroyed. Due to Posidonia's slow growth, the wounds inflicted on the meadow can take up to a century to heal. However, some of these works must still be carried out for reasons of prevailing public interest. Many of these works involve environmental impact assessments. When the works that are carried out are in the vicinity of Posidonia meadows or will directly affect them, and the Posidonia meadows are protected by the Natura 2000 network, it is necessary to intervene with mitigation and compensation measures. Posidonia transplantation is the most common compensation technique used in Italy in the context of environmental impact assessment. Since the 1970s, marine biologists have begun to develop different transplant techniques to help suffering Posidonia meadows restore their plant cover faster.
I too am a former student of Eugenio Fresi, an Italian marine biologist. As early as the 70s, he came into contact with a group called the Sea Gardeners from France. And in particular, one of these sea gardeners was called Couper and had devised a method to bind the rhizomes of Posidonia to the seabed.
Italy is the Mediterranean nation that has invested most in research and experimentation of Posidonia transplants. In addition to small experimental transplants, more extensive ones have been carried out, both for the recovery of degraded meadows and to compensate for the damage caused by coastal works and infrastructures. To compensate for the damage caused to the protected meadow of La Mattonara due to the creation of a dock in the port of Civitavecchia for the adjacent enol plant between August 2004 and March 2005, the transplant of 1 hectare of Posidonia was carried out in Santa Marinella, representing the largest and longest lasting transplant in the Mediterranean to date.
The project carried out in Santa Marinella, as mandated by the Environmental Impact Assessments Committee, consisted in the transplantation of about 300,000 shoots of Posidonia over a total area of 1 hectare. The transplant modules laid out consisted of concrete frames armed with metal mesh, which was the fruit of the sea gardeners and modified to be less imposing. The same method, used in Santa Marinella, was used for another smaller but important project in Ischia, where it was necessary to compensate for the damage caused by the excavation of the trench for the laying of a pipeline that connects Ischia to the continent at Bacoli.
The Port Authority of Piombino had to expand the port according to the port master plan, and in doing so, we would have destroyed a large portion of Posidonia meadow in front of the entrance to the port. For this reason, in the environmental impact assessment procedure, we proposed to the Ministry of the Environment to transfer clods of 4 square meters of meadow to an adjacent area in the Gulf of Thessalonica. In 2014, 314 clods were transferred. It was a very complex and delicate operation, also because this is not a real transplant, but a transfer of portions of meadow that also included underlying mate. In 2014, in the Rada di Augusta, in the locality of Seno di Priolo, a transplant was carried out to restore the pre-existing meadow. Using bioplastic supports, more than 60,000 shoots were taken from a nearby meadow and transplanted.
Here we've set up a reforestation plant, which over an area of roughly 2 hectares of meadow is trying to restore the plant cover on areas where Posidonia was previously present, but sadly gone today.
Although transplantation represents a real possibility to recover a retreating or damaged meadow, its outcome, at times uncertain, generates heated debates in the scientific community and in public opinion.
Reforestation projects generally have considerable weaknesses on a global level. The literature tells us that these problems are often due to the wrong choice of placement and the system of attachment to the substrate.
The European project LIFE SEPOSSO, coordinated by ISPRA, the Italian Institute for Environmental Protection and Research, together with its partners and many others, aims to verify the outcome of the transplants carried out to date in Italy and to understand how to improve them. The SEPOSSO project has verified certain fundamental points. First of all, whether the transplants were done in the best possible manner, from a technical and scientific point of view.
We've looked for official and public data regarding the outcome of the transplants carried out in the past in Italy, and we've found very little and often with great difficulty. We've decided to go and check the conditions of these transplants underwater. In 2018 and 19, we carried out more than 50 dives for a total of 500 hours of work. Today, we have the necessary information to tell how these transplants actually went. In Santa Marinella, 15 years after the transplant, the result is very interesting and very positive in some of the areas that have survived. Now, due to the particularly harsh weather conditions and mainly due to illegal fishing that has done extensive damage to the meadow, we've lost about 60% in total of the transplant modules. The remaining 40%, however, now has the same densities of the real meadow that has come to form in this area.
In Ischia, although some areas were damaged by storms and anchors, the transplant went well overall. After 10 years in one of the monitored transplant areas, a meadow fully comparable to the surrounding natural one was observed. In Piombino, after 5 years, about 25% of the clods have been lost. Of the remaining ones, some have been well preserved, while 50% are gradually integrating with their surroundings, while some others are falling apart.
But it's still too early to say how this transplant really went. We still need a few more years of monitoring because it's now clear that it's essential to monitor the effectiveness of a transplant for a long time. Over the years, we've seen many transplants to be monitored, at the island of Elba in Capolivere and Cavo, on the island of Giglio after the shipwreck of the Concordia, in Sicily, in Syracuse and Mondello. In Sardinia, we then participated in the monitoring conducted by the protected marine area of Capo Carbonara for the reforestation of a portion of the damaged meadow. Quite a challenge. The results have shown us that, for example, it's essential to carry out small experimental transplants as tests before making them more extensive, to make very careful assessments to choose the best transplant techniques, and to select the areas where a transplant is most likely to succeed. But it's also important to understand where it's best not to do it at all.
All the technical and scientific results obtained and the good practices carried out in the LIFE SEPOSSO project will allow the best planning and realization of future transplants of Posidonia, so that they can be truly an effective recovery tool for such an important habitat. It has also been crucial to check whether all those directly or indirectly involved in the construction of the marine coastal works had general knowledge of Posidonia Oceanica, and whether they had been informed of the realization of the transplants required to compensate for the damage to the meadows and what the results to these transplants had been.
Very few of those interviewed know what Posidonia Oceanica is and what its functions are, and almost no one was aware that transplants have been carried out and what function they served. The only exception were the researchers and some technicians working for the industries that carry out maritime projects and the managers of the administration offices. It's important to continue to keep the general population informed, even after the transplant has been carried out, to make clear the success or possible failure of transplant activities. Ideally, everyone involved in various ways in Posidonia transplants should share a single working tool. This is why we've created an innovative web platform where we can centralize the data of the projects that impact the Posidonia meadows, plan any transplants, and monitor and oversee the various phases over time, as well as make all the monitoring data and results available to the public.
Lastly, everyone had to be made aware that respecting the Posidonia meadows also means safeguarding the natural capital present and the ecosystem services they provide to mankind and the environment.
When planning the construction of something in a coastal area, the meadows could be damaged. We must know that many of the essential services would also be lost, such as increasing marine biodiversity, providing nutrition and a refuge to many species, including many of the fish caught by our fleets, defending beaches from erosion and increasing tourism in coastal areas. Giving economic value to these services also means estimating the damage done to the Posidonia meadows and assessing the right compensation.
Together with our partners, we have worked to provide the various parties involved with specific solutions for a more effective and sustainable management of the Posidonia Oceanica meadows. The meadows of Posidonia Oceanica are a common heritage for guaranteeing the health of the sea and of man. Only a constant synergy between scientific research, government actions, and the conscious participation of citizens can truly guarantee the protection and recovery of this habitat. It is necessary for each of us to look after it.